Welcome back to our channel, friends. Forensic Science Public Desk India, and now we are going to learn about the National Forensic Sciences University Act 2020. That there is a new university established, that is the National Forensic Sciences University, and we are going to learn about that. And let's proceed. General topics about the Act, authorities who are related to this particular Act, objectives of the Act, powers associated, and also the functions, funds, appeals, etc. will be discussed in this particular video. Let's proceed. The National Forensic Sciences University Bill 2020 introduced in Lok Sabha on 23rd March 2020, and the bill was passed in Lok Sabha on 20th September 2020, and the bill was passed from Rajya Sabha as well on 22nd September 2020. So it has not taken much time. In very shorter period of time, this bill has been passed in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and the National Forensic Sciences University Act of Parliament received assent of the President on the 28th September 2020, and this particular bill was proposed by Ministry of Home Affairs, as it is announced by our Ministry of Home Affairs Minister Mr. Amit Shah of Government of India. So this particular bill will be very helpful from that particular point when it was announced by the minister. The hope of this particular act is increasing in forensic science fraternity, and today on 23rd September 2020 it has been released, and the people are very happy. Hopefully everyone are having very good expectations from the particular act and various things which are associated with the University Act, and hopefully we'll be learning very good things related to this. About this particular act, if you see, an act to establish and declare an institution to be known as National Forensic Sciences University as an institute of national importance, to facilitate and promote studies and research, and to achieve excellence in field of forensic science in conjugation with applied behavioral sciences studies, law, criminology and other allied areas, and technology and other related fields, and to provide for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto. That means all these subjects, whatever are there, very randomly distributed in various universities and courses offered by various private colleges and institutions with very rigid kind of platforms and rigid kind of syllabus and curriculum. Now these are going to become very uniform, hopefully, by this particular act. Chapter 1 deals with the preliminary. That means it is having three clauses in it. First one is the short title and the commencement. Short title is the National Forensic Sciences University, and the commencement is on 28th September 2020. Declaration of National Forensic Sciences University as an institution of national importance by the Government of India as per the notification, the Gazette of India Extraordinary. And the third act, third clause, if you see, we are having various definitions, A, B, C, D, like that, so on till V. We are having various definitions. You can learn those definitions better by referring the particular act, whatever it is there. So some of the definitions you can look, like the academic council, academic staff, affiliated colleges, dean, department, distance education system, teachers, university, vice chancellor, etc. What are the various words which are commonly used, and what are their definitions, and what is their power limit? In one definition it can be said. So further, if you proceed, we are having chapter 2, in which there are two important things: establishment of university, most important part, and the effect of incorporation of the university. So these particular two acts are very important to be understood for every individual who are there in the forensic science. The Gujarat Forensic Sciences University, which is situated at Gandhinagar, Gujarat, established under Gujarat Forensic Sciences University Act 2008, and the Loknayak Jayaprakash Narayan National Institute of Criminology and Forensic Sciences, New Delhi, shall be established as an university by the name of National Forensic Sciences University. So previously, if you see, the National Institute of Criminology and the Forensic Sciences are affiliated to another college, Guru Gobind University, which is situated at Delhi. Now the current academic year, whatever it is going on, current students who are affiliated under that university will be going on in that university only, and degrees will be provided by that university only. The students who are going to admitted newly into NICFS or the GFSU, now they are going to be recognized by university NFSU. Okay, so that's a good news, and this good news, let's prolong it and understand more about this good news. So sixth clause, objects of university, very important, in which we are going to understand various objectives of creating such university and this particular act, and the powers and functions of this university, how it will be going to be worked, so that too in national level, and how it is going to affect the education system in forensic science. So point wise, if you see, first the objectives: to facilitate and promote academic learning and practices in the field of forensic science, including training, skill development and the research. So this particular things will be more promoted, and this will be facilitated by the university. To foster research and applied applications in forensic sciences for training, research development, by promoting innovations and best practices. That means obviously whatever the subject we are learning, and we are going to apply it for various types of crimes, and we are going to solve the crimes, and also developing certain kind of research which will also give us the very good database. Not only that, standard protocols to conduct the research on various crimes. To promote and provide advanced institutional and research facilities in field of forensic science. To maintain a uniformity, that point means to maintain a uniformity. To create capacities and capabilities of global standards of education, training and research for development of aptitude, skills, knowledge. So to reach the international level, that is globalizing this particular platform, the education platform of forensic science, to the level of international. To coordinate with central government and state government to improve investigation, crime detection, prevention through projects and research funded by grants and aid from central government and state government. So the whatever the research work, whatever the projects which are going to be held at the university are going to be funded by central and state governments, and the coordination between the central and state government is also be pronounced here. So the crime detection and prevention are going to be well established, and we can do much better work in crime solving. To formulate relevant policies, including their review in the field of forensic science. Okay, so this you can understand, creating relevant policies which will be giving very good platform for forensic sciences and the regulations. Continuing the objectives, seventh objective: to coordinate and network with institutions having specialization so as to expand the fields of forensic sciences. So the whatever the network and coordination is there as of now is so poor, and I can say many of the universities, especially if you can see Gujarat Forensic Science University or the Amity Forensic Science Institute, whatever they are there, so their syllabus was not been shared so far. So now with this particular university act, I hope all the syllabus, all the curriculum of various universities, those who are offering forensic sciences, will be revealing their particular syllabuses and helping the whole forensic science fraternity to get very good information about this particular thing, and to administer, maintain and manage the university, and to establish such of site campus and offshore centers for education, training and research. So this will be very helpful, that not only in the campus, in actual main campus, but also various others or colleges are going to be established by the university. That means the present university is in Gandhinagar, as well as there is an institute at Delhi. Not only these two, Pune, Mumbai, Hyderabad, hopefully Chennai and other main important metro cities are going to get institutes from side of this particular university. To assist the CFSL, SFSLs for standard operating procedures, the procedure, whatever SOPs which are there in the laboratories are also be going to be designed by the experts and the professors, researchers from this particular universities and research centers, lay down the specifications for forensic equipments and kits to be used for forensic work in the country. So they are going to design all related things to make the work easy at a real field, that means in the forensic science laboratories or it can be the crime scene. To establish campus, colleges, schools, centers, institutions of excellence for imparting state-of-the-art education, training research in fields of forensic science, cyber security, and digital forensics, behavioral science, technology, and management. So these are most important. Forensic science is a limit. So very, very particular subjects like the biology, physics, chemistry can be seen in that. So that is up to only certain limit and very basically dealt. So establishing a university for such kind of thing is not so necessary, but considering cybersecurity, digital forensic sciences, behavioral sciences, technology especially, and the management system which should be established in forensic science field, all this together are making the certainty to compulsorily establish a university. So that is why the university is there now, and to maintain certain kind of standards as per it is set, to set up campuses, colleges all around the country with very good standards. So that is what the thing about the 10th point. And to assist, create, maintain national forensic database, very important point here it is mentioned, for criminal investigation, including maintaining the database for criminal purposes, that is fingerprints, though Aadhaar card fingerprints and iris detection etc. are maintained, but those are not used for the criminal purposes. So now this particular act is also saying that the research and development should be giving us a proper database, and it should be maintained to give us the details about various fingerprints, voice data of various culprits or the recognized calls, DNA fingerprinting database, firearms database, counterfeiting currency database, narcotic drugs, psychotropic substances, cyber security, cyber defense, and internal security. All this database is going to be maintained under this particular act. So it is not yet commenced. In future, hopefully, we'll be having all this data. If this data is available, the crime solving, crime prevention, detection is going to be becoming very simple and very easy. So this is a turning point to undertake special projects for central government and state governments. It is already mentioned and it is already learned. So these are the objectives. So let's proceed into chapter 2 continued. So hereafter there are certain general points. So previous points which were discussed were the objectives that every individual from forensic science should be understanding and knowing. And after this, there are certain points all the management people or one who are running the colleges for forensic science, universities, one which are running for forensic science courses, etc., they should be knowing this particular point. Jurisdiction of the university. So up to certain extent, all India, Union Territory, states are having this jurisdiction of university. University to be open to all races, creeds and classes, there is no difference. The admission process is equal to all. And admission of the students, there are certain provisions which are given. So students who are getting admitted in 2020 will be having the university under NFSU. And those who have been in university already since before this particular act, they will be coming under GFSU. And teaching at the university, so what are the particular standards which are there, those are going to be discussed in this particular chapter 2. So chapter 3 deals with authorities of university. We are having various authorities, not going very deep into the particular thing each one. So let's have a glance over it. Authorities of university, we are having chancellor, main chancellor, that can be a governor, or we are having court, a tribunal is there to solve all kind of issues related to the university, students, admissions, recruitment, etc., whatever are there, which will be dealt by the court. And board of governors will be there, who will be dealing with actual university matters and management kind of things and administration. Power of boards of governors. So in 15 it is mentioned about board of governors. Now the powers of board of governors and the terms of office of members of board of governors. So what will be the basic term which will be there for each governor? So that will be mentioned in this. And academic council. So academic council is very important to design whatever kind of things which are required for the implementation and the main functioning of this particular university. Power of academic council, what are the powers will be there. So officers of a university, various other officers who are involved, it can be the controller of examination or it can be the placements, whatever it is there. Different officers will be coming under this particular section. Coming to vice chancellor, he will be the head and he will be particular institutional administrator. who will be running the university all around, and powers of vice chancellor are discussed in clause 22, and 23 is campus directors. So the various institutions will be there. For each institute, directors will be there, and their roles are different. It can be any kind of director, so all the directors can be discussed under 23 clause. And we are having deans, various deans for different institutes, different activities at the university, executive registrar, finance officer dealing with financial things and other officers. Financial committee will be also set up to conduct the audit and to see all the kind of financial material in the university. Powers of financial committee is also being discussed to 29 clause 30, board of affiliation and recognition. So maintaining that particular thing and putting all the things together, standards and what are the new outcomes which are there and new additions. So all these things and affiliating all other colleges into this particular university and recognizing the forensic science courses and other officers of university. It is the third time we are seeing this, and grants by the central government, grants by the state government will also be seen under the chapter 3. Chapter 4, accounts and audit. So it is completely related to the finance committee and finance officers. Corps of the university, so whatever the amount, whatever the maintenance is there, that will be there in 34. 35 is the fund, so it can be the donation, it can be the gift, or it can be the any kind of amount which is given to the university to maintain its financial state. And 36 is accounts and audit, controlling it, maintaining it, and doing a certain kind of inspection to all these particular accounts and doing the auditing. Then 37, pensions and provident funds related to the employees. Chapter 5, annual report and appointments. Annual report will be given by the university every year. So in that annual report, all the activities, all the achievements, all the particular things which are relevant to the university will be announced in that particular annual report. And this annual report, generally any annual report will be having the statistical report. So all the statistical report will also be revealed by the university to the public. And the appointments of the officers of university will also be coming under this particular chapter, where a new officers after that term is being completed will be there in this. Chapter number 6 is dealing with statutes and ordinances. Statutes, what are the various authorities and what are the powers of each authorities and how they are going to execute those particular authorities, and which regulations and what are those regulations will be discussed in 40 and 41 clauses. And there are certain procedures, as like we see in CRPC, how the procedures are followed. Here also statutes and ordinances are going to control the powers of main authorities, that is a board of governors, or it can be the chancellor or vice chancellor. So whatever are there, it can be the appointment of the particular employees, or it can be the admission, management, delegation and abolishment of the admissions, or abolishment of the affiliation of various colleges, can all be there as particular the procedures assigned to various authorities in the universities. Chapter number 7, and it is dealing with the Tribunal of Arbitration. Tribunal of Arbitration, redressal of debarment from examination, disciplinary action against the students, all these things, as like we have discussed in the part of court. So here it is actually mentioned in the chapter number 7. So in this particular chapter, all the related things, issues which are legally bound to university policies and university regulations, these are at question at that time. This particular thing, the Tribunal of Arbitration is going to deal and solve the problems. Chapter number 8 is the miscellaneous, where it starts with disputes as to constitution of authorities and bodies. So it will be very high level, and the power of central government to make rules in respect of matters relating to board of governors, act and proceeding to be invalidated by vacancies, etc. So related to vacancies, whatever are there. University to be a public authority under Right of Information Act, so it is also be there here. Right to Information is there, RTI, so that you can ask any information which is relevant to university. Protection of action taken in good faith is also be there. Power of central government to issue directions, residuary provision, laying of rules, statutes, ordinances and notices, power to remove difficulties, translational provisions, reappeal of Gujarat Act 17 of 2019, 2008. So all these are also there. You can refer this better. So instead of understanding here, so making the video short and providing only essential things which are there. So main thing which we have to understand is there is uniformity in forensic science education right from now. After this university has been established, all the colleges which are there in India providing forensic science courses, better they get affiliation from the university so that they can maintain a uniform and a very nice curriculum to all students and provide equal amount of opportunities after completion of their education, and giving one certain kind of a certification degree to all the students will be more uniform and giving more power and strength to the student career. So all the colleges, all the students must know about this particular act. Whenever they are joining in the university, whenever they are getting admission, they are most lucky enough, and understanding this particular act will be one of the important point so that it will be helping in their career of forensic science. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you have understood all the concepts related to the Natural Forensic Sciences University, and also thankful to the Government of India to enacting this particular act, and it is very helpful for the students and also forensic science education.